My name is Tyler Vandenberg. I'm a sales engineer at Inspired Flight, and today I'm going to show you how to set up the IF750 and prepare it for flight. So the first thing we're going to do is assemble the landing gear. When you put the vertical section into the T-tube, make sure that it's fully seated by twisting. You'll feel it lock into place, and then use the ratcheting clamp on the side to twist and make sure it's tight. I'm going to set the first one aside and do the second one. Same thing. With both of those set aside and ready to grab, we're going to lift up the aircraft by the middle handle and grab one of the landing gear. They go right into the side next to the antennas here that are on the side. Same thing, notches right into place in the socket, twist the ratcheting clamp on the side, grab the other one. Once those are tightened, you can set the aircraft down. Once everything's assembled, next step is to unfold the arms. To do this, simply lift the arms and the shoulders will lock into place automatically. Next, we have the GPS mast. Lift the GPS mast all the way until it stops. Then the two clips on the side come right around and lock it into place. What you'll want to do next is put on the battery packs. So these will go right under the Velcro straps on both sides. So unfasten the Velcro straps and grab your battery pack. You'll want to make sure that the balance lead on the battery pack is facing down to make sure that it doesn't get caught up in the props, and that the main lead of the battery pack is facing the rear of the vehicle so it plugs into the port on the side. Fasten it down with the Velcro straps. Then we'll do the other side. Same thing, main power lead in the back, balance lead on the bottom. And don't worry about plugging it in yet, because we're going to put the props on next. We'll go ahead and unbag each of the props. Set them aside. There will be two counterclockwise spinning props and two clockwise spinning props. And the way to differentiate those two is by looking at the circular hardware underneath. Two of them will be black and two of them will be silver. And those pieces correspond with the attachment points on the motor. So what you're going to want to do is find the silver etched dot, and there's going to be one on the prop side and on the motor side. And those two, when the dots are lined up, it'll fit right down into place. Once the prop is sitting there, you'll want to grab the included torque driver, which is preset to 0.9 Newton meters. And with this driver, you'll go ahead and spin the first screw down until the prop starts to spin. Then you'll do the next screw. And the second screw, you're going to do all the way until it clicks, meaning it's at the proper torque. Then you'll go back to the first screw. Now both are seated evenly and tightened properly. We'll then do the rest of the three remaining props. Next, we'll attach our payload. This particular payload is the Gremsy S1 with a Sony camera, which is great for photogrammetry and other inspection purposes. To put on any of the Gremsy gimbals, you'll find a white mark both on the gimbal and on the gimbal attachment. And with those lined up, it sits right up into place vertically, and then you twist clockwise to lock it into place, and you'll feel it click. We'll cover balancing a gimbal and the various payloads in another video. After our payload is attached, we're gonna go ahead and grab the hand controller. Your hand controller may vary depending on which package you've purchased, but this controller in particular is the HereLink Blue made by Union Robotics. We'll power on the hand controller by holding the power button, and we'll let it do its boot up sequence. Now that the controller is powered on, we're gonna go ahead and open Q ground control on the screen, unfold the antennas into a proper position, and power on the vehicle. So to power on the 750, all you have to do is plug in the two yellow connectors on the side, and you'll hear it go through its startup sequence. If there's a payload attached, you'll also notice it go through a startup sequence. Now that everything is set up and powered on, it's time for our pre-flight checklist, which can be found in the next video.